What's a clever way you have avoided paying for something? Parking permits for my university were ridiculously expensive since it was in a downtown area. I'm talking like $700 a year minimum. I only had class 3 days a week, so it didn't make sense to pay for a semester-long permit. Right next to the university is a movie theater with its own parking structure. Parking is validated with the purchase of a movie ticket. This particular movie theater has a deal for university students on weekdays. $3 movie tickets if you show your student ID. So instead of parking at the university lots, I would park in the theater lots, buy a $3 ticket and then just go to class. I'd get my parking ticket validated and go home. I'd estimate I spent about $250 each year doing this. After a while, I signed up for some sort of point system the theater offered that got me an insane amount of perks, since as far as they knew, I was watching 3 movies a week at their establishment. Essentially, I saved $450 a year and got multiple free movie tickets and merch out of it. That's what I call a win-win-win. You're saving money and get kickbacks. The movie theater makes money, and there is more parking freed up on campus for everyone else to use. When my son was about to be born, we had to stay a while at the hospital and the parking time bill racked up really quickly. Been there for 4 to 5 days, so that was about $15-$20 per day. But you only had to pay a $20 fine to get out if you lost your ticket. Let's say I played the "I lost my parking ticket, I'm so sorry" game. I do the same thing at my apartment building when friends visit me. It doesn't matter how many days they stay, because we can just hit the lost ticket button and pay the fee for one day. I have no moral qualms about it. The parking in my neighborhood is stupid expensive and we don't get any guest spaces. 8th grade school book fair with a buy one get one free sale. I had $20 and wanted 4 books. 2 books cost $11 each. The other 2 cost $8 each. With these sales, they always make the 2 cheaper items free, so I would have ended up spending $22, which I knew I couldn't afford. So, I took the $2.11 books up and paid for them, so one of them was free. Then, I pretended to discover the $2.08 books I also wanted and paid for those. I ended up with enough left over to buy myself a cool eraser on top of it all. I hope that cool eraser can erase that dark smudge on your soul, young man. If you try to cancel an appointment during the time in which there's a cancellation fee, ask if you can reschedule for a later date to avoid the fee. Then once they give you the new appointment date outside of the cancellation fee required period, then ask to cancel said new appointment. Boom, roasted. This can work for hotel reservations, too. I parked in a parking structure for 3 days that was $10 HR with a $30 day maximum. On the way back to the car on the 3rd day, I noticed a sign that said if you lost your ticket, you have to pay a full day's rate of $30. So I lost it and paid for only 1 day. I fly to Atlanta from SFO often. I would fly in the morning and always buy the cheaper of 2 tickets, which is a layover in Denver. The other flight is a direct route that costs on average about $100 more. When I get to the airport, I always overbook the Denver flight 100% of the time and ask for volunteers to change their flight for a voucher. I volunteer, get the voucher, and they put me on the direct flight to Atlanta. I've done it a dozen times. I book through my company and save them money, and I get to keep the voucher for myself. It's win-win. I separate large Amazon orders into individual no-rush orders. Then I order something with 2-day shipping. 90% of the time, Amazon will throw everything into one box. So you get everything in the usual time and you get the bonus $1 reward for every no-rush item. You can't avoid paying for digital items from Amazon this way. Got my home air conditioning fixed for $4 at 3 a.m. On a Sunday, I got a call from the realtor at 7 p.m. On a Sunday that the house I was selling the next day at 8 a.m. had a broken air conditioner. I couldn't allow the sale of my house to fall through. I went to the house and tried to fix it, failed, and ended up calling a host of AC companies to see if I could get someone out there on short notice. No one would touch it without a service contract. Standard rate was 3 years at about $120 a month. In desperation, I called one of them back and asked what the cancellation policy was. There was a $3,000 cancellation fee, but if you sold your house and provided proof, the fee was waived. I signed up on the spot for their deluxe package with 24/7 1-hour on-call repair services. A repairman showed up 45 minutes later and fixed my AC. Closed on the sale of the house the next day and immediately sent via certified mail copies of documentation showing the house had been sold and was out of my name along with a check for the prorated amount of my bill, around $4. I really hate that the repair companies were trying to force people into BS years-long contracts, but I think I won that one in the end. Admittedly, in the vast majority of those cases people wouldn't be in a position to sell the house near immediately, so the air con companies probably aren't too worried that a tiny fraction of people might be able to do this. At university, paying for parking for every class was such balls. I noticed that the person who checks tickets never really came around and if they did it was at a certain predictable time. Also, if you were to get a ticket, no points were taken, just a small fine. Actually, a really small fine. They only charged something like $8. So it made mathematical sense to never pay for parking and to always pay the ticket if you got one. It was way cheaper than paying through the university tolls. When I was a kid and had bigger balls and more time, I would buy a ticket for a movie starting at 11 a.m. and then basically spend the whole day inside the theater watching movie after movie till midnight. A movie would end, I'd go to the bathroom, stay there till the next showtime and then just walk into the next showing. This works better during the weekdays, less theater workers to catch you. For non-rated R movies, less of a chance there'll be a doorman right at the door of the theater. And in sad theaters that don't get a ton of business and are staffed by teenagers who just don't give a frick. Back in the olden days before mobile phones were common, if I needed to call home I'd just call the operator from a payphone and say that I'd put a quarter in but my call didn't go through, and then they'd connect me for free. Back in the day, we'd call collect and if we used the dog's name, my parents knew to pick us up and would decline the charges. Sometimes I use those Visa gift cards. I use up the money and then use the empty card for any free trial you have to use a credit card for. It lasts until payment is due and then it just cancels the account. Sometimes it takes out a dollar from the card and puts it back in just to make sure you can actually pay if you don't cancel the subscription. Just make sure you have a small amount left on the card. I did try this with Netflix but I had less money on the card than what the subscription was worth so it didn't end up working. In college a student engineering society was having a meeting in Hawaii for student leadership. The professional conference it was linked with was there. My school didn't have a chapter so I made one. Got some of my friends to sign up for it to legitimize it and made myself president. They paid for me to go to Hawaii for a week, all expenses paid. I had to bluff my way through one meeting with other student leaders from the other university chapters but after that I could do whatever I wanted. Food, transportation and my stay in a very nice resort were all paid for. During my first year of college I had a chemistry class that the final would only allow a scientific calculator but would not allow a graphing calculator which I already owed for calculus. Being that I was a college student I didn't really want to shell out $25 for a scientific calculator when I already had a better calculator and would only use it for 2-3 hours during the final. So I ended up going to Walmart and realizing that the calculators would work still in the packaging so long as I pushed hard enough through the plastic to hit the buttons. So I ended up buying it to only return it after the final was over. While working at Sunglass Hut, it was fairly common for people to walk in, take their $20 pair of sunglasses off their head and try on a pair of $200 Ray-Bans, put the crappy ones where the Ray-Bans were on the shelf and walk right out, with 500 pairs of glasses in the store that all look alike. Unless I watched it happen it would usually go undiscovered for hours. The real crime is charging $200 for sunglasses. This wasn't intentional, and I could probably never achieve it again, but I once got access to a private beach with a $60 entry fee for the day because I ran out of gas. My ex-girlfriend and I were looking to go to a beach for the day and I thought of this awesome little secluded beach that my friends and I always went to at night to hang out. We always went past sundown so we never had to pay, but on this day we showed up at about 11 a.m. to get some sun in. My old car had a broken gas meter. So when you turn the car on it would be accurate but after driving a few miles the meters would go to empty. But I misjudged that day and while pulling up to the booth my car turns off, and I am completely out of gas. The guy doesn't realize and asks me for $60. Again, I had never been there in the daytime, so I had no idea it was going to be that expensive. I told him we would just leave then, but I told him I had a problem with my car and needed to put gas in. I showed him the issue, and told him I would call AAA to bring some gas. He looks around and says, "You know what? No charge. Just go hang out on the beach and wait for them to come with the gas. If you stay after you gas up, I don't know a thing." So we sat on the beach 4 hours with people who had way more money than us. I could never have timed that so perfectly. AAA came after a half hour, but we took advantage of it. I just keep signing up and cancelling Netflix free trials every month with a different email address. Sometimes they'll catch on with detecting the same credit card number, so I'll use a virtual account number from my bank and they won't know. I micromanage a lot of things, but I don't think I could micromanage this every month. But kudos. When I was still at school, I jammed the table football table with some folded paper so that the 50p piece was in the perfect position to let the balls through. Endless games, until the school's janitor unjammed it, and so started a back and forth that I won. My last jam lasted the whole of the final term till I graduated. The whole of sixth form used that table. I must cost the school a couple of grand at least. Joke's on you. The janitor ran an underground betting ring on your games and made off with the cash. Entering competitions and contests used to be like a serious hobby and little income stream of mine. Didn't pay to see a film at the cinema in years and went regularly. The phone I'm writing this on, won it. Trip to Sydney, thanks MTV. Concerts, DVDs, CDs, magazine subscriptions, books, heaps of random crap all for free. Even won a freaking axe once. Crap like this is why I believe in luck being a quantifiable stat, and that I have a zero in that category. One time I pre-ordered Call of Duty on Amazon just to play the demo. Once I played the demo, I called Amazon and they let me know I couldn't cancel digital good. I pre-ordered the digital version. Since I knew I wasn't going to play the game because I didn't enjoy the demo, I had to do something. So, I just waited until right before the release date, drained my account that Amazon was attached to, and they then emailed me to let me know the card didn't process and that they will be cancelling the pre-order. Take that. Something similar happened to me. I forgot I had pre-ordered something and months later, I had a withdrawal on my credit card and I had no idea where it came from. I called my bank, got a refund and a new card. Few weeks later I got a book from Amazon in my mails. Oops, got myself a free $30 signed some books off Amazon's back. I haven't done this on purpose, but I found a way to ride the city bus for free. Our public transit system has one of those plastic card programs, the ones that you can reload with money, etc. Instead of using cash to buy your tickets, a few months ago my bus pass card demagnetized or something. So when I went to tap it on the reader, it didn't register. I knew I had money on it, so I must have looked pretty exasperated as I tried over and over to swipe it. The bus driver took pity on me and just waved me in without paying. I thought maybe it was a malfunction of the card reader and forgot about it. A few weeks later I had to get across the city, which required several connections. Lo and behold, card still doesn't register when I tap it. Again, the bus driver saw my look of confusion and waved me in. It happened again on the connecting bus, and then the next one. I figured that if I wanted to, I could continue to play dumb and use my demagnetized card for free bus rides. I'm lame, however, and got the problem fixed by calling their 800 number and getting a new card. I pay my wife a salary from my company to avoid the tax on the earnings, and the higher rate of tax that I would have to pay if the money went to me. It's legal. Dude, you know she's having an affair with her boss. I've been with my internet provider for like 15 years, and I have no intention of switching, but now and then their competitor in town knocks on my door and offers me a really good deal if I switch. So I call my ISP and pretend like I'm going to cancel my service and switch. They start throwing all kinds of discounts and upgrades at me, like a bald fat loser begging his GF not to leave. By the end of the call, I'm paying half price for better service. I don't really feel bad about this scam. Though, we're paying $160 a month for service Europeans get for $20. Paying $80 a month for a 6-month deal is still a ripoff, but oligopoly and all that. That's one of the few responses on this thread that isn't a scam or theft. In grade 12, the public transit in my city decided to make public transit free for anyone under 12. It's taken like 3-4 years for them to give kids a special pass that they can only get by proving their age. Now you may ask, why would they do that? That's a massive financial loss and probably really freaking annoying when a whole school boards and only the teachers have to pay the fare. Your guess is as good as mine. Me, who was still late to the puberty game and chronically is mistaken for a child to this day, I'm 21, realized that if I had my hair in pigtails and I wore clothes that covered up a body, I could go to and from school for free. Never got caught since fare inspectors never got on that route outside of school hours. Not exactly clever, but one time, when I was younger, I didn't pay a speeding ticket. This was like 20 years ago. I never heard a single thing about this ticket the whole rest of my life. It just kinda disappeared. It's not on my record. I've received several driver's licenses since then. It's very weird and very lucky. The cop either did not end up filing it, or simply forgot to. This happened to me once, and after an extensive investigation I found out that the cop felt bad for writing me the ticket and didn't file it. During college, at a Chick-fil-A Express, where all the items are just there to grab and pay at register, all the staff members were just talking to each other and I stood there waiting to pay, money in hand, for 2 minutes, no acknowledgement. So I turned to put the food back and then one of the cashiers asked if I wanted any sauce. Turning back around with food in hand and a fist of ones, she gave me sauce and said, "Next in line." I walked out of the cafeteria with free Chick-fil-A. One day I got on the train and rode one stop outside the free zone. When I got off, I saw the fare inspectors checking everyone as they passed the gates. Quickly I got my phone out and proceeded to have a fantastic meltdown with my imaginary girlfriend. I was hopping, pacing, punching imaginary things, and yelling my heart out. I figured that if I could keep it up long enough, the next train would come, and the inspectors would switch their focus. Worked exactly as planned. Felt dang proud of myself too. And yes, I did apologize to my imaginary GF afterwards. I think more people might do this if not for dignity and self-respect. A friend of mine would get the book and reading list for all of his classes, get to campus early and check them out of the library. He would keep them to the end of the semester and pay the fine. Saved a lot of money. As a bonus, other students won't be able to check out the book, and if the class is curved your grade will be better. Buying gift cards at Costco does not require a membership. Using gift cards at Costco allows you to shop there without a membership, even if your gift card is only for $5. Step 1. Buy a bunch of gift cards without membership for $5 each. Step 2. Shop at Costco without membership, but with at least one gift card. Step 3. Profit. Purchased some diamond earrings online for my girlfriend from a major jeweler. Box came damaged, so I called the store and requested a new box to be sent. A few days later I received a new box. The next day I received another new box, but this one came with a set of earrings. Wasn't charged for it, so I walked my happy butt down to the closest store and returned one of the set of earrings for a full refund, with my girlfriend wearing the same ones in the store. Risk III. It was unintentional, but I bought a set of overalls at full price, took them home and they were one size too small. Took them back a few days later when there happened to be a sale on in the shop. Got the correct size overalls and a pack of socks, took them to the till and said about the wrong size, etc. And they swapped the overalls, but because there was a sale on, I had store credit, so got the socks for free and a small refund returned. Happened again on another occasion too. Usually stores will do a price adjustment if something goes on sale like that. They'll refund you or give you store credit for the difference. Bought an expensive jacket on eBay. It arrived and was really good quality but was fake. Asked for money back and the seller gave me the big frick you. Contacted eBay for a refund. They said yes, as long as I send the jacket back to the seller. I refuse, saying it's illegal to ship counterfeit goods abroad. I get refunded, plus got to keep the jacket. Well, eBay told me to destroy it, but, you know, I then send pic of me wearing the jacket and a copy of my refund email to the C seller. He get mad, I laugh heartily. eBay, and Amazon too, if I recall correctly, are serious as heck about their counterfeit goods policies. They'll refund your purchase no questions asked if you buy something that you genuinely believe is the real deal and you get a fake. You're not required to return the item either, because then the seller can just sell it again. Not me, but a girl I work with. We work in a plaza, and when the power goes out she goes to a fast food joint in our plaza that she knows has issues taking payment when the power goes out. She's gone multiple times and gets free lunch each time. Back when the toll booth spit out tickets via a machine, I would sit there and take multiple tickets. I would then have a ton of tickets from each on ramp along the highway. Then when I would go drive somewhere, I would get off whatever exit I needed to and find the ticket that was for the previous on ramp. So instead of paying $3 for driving 10 exits, I paid $0.25, since it seemed like I only drove on the highway for a few miles. The Kansas Turnpike still does the tickets and they're time stamped. If your ticket shows you spent too much time, you have to pay the maximum fare for the whole turnpike as if you drove the entire thing. I work at a restaurant that takes online orders. We get the order, print the receipt which has all the information for what they want. If the customer wanted, they could include special directions, which would appear below whatever item they put the directions for. Sometimes, customers would pay for a bottled water, but put special directions saying they want sweet tea with extra ice. The way the ticket printed made it seem like they paid for both, so they sometimes got a free drink. My boss caught onto it fast, thankfully. Their face when they'd come to pick it up and tried to complain for paying for something we didn't give them was priceless. See, my brother refuses to pay for the Hulu we share, basically saying I don't use it, B, who else is watching Steven Universe. So at the end of the month I sneak $12 out of his room. He hasn't noticed and I heard him bragging about how he has free Hulu. At Chipotle, Qdoba, Moe's, or any of the other quick Mexican eat spots, they do not charge extra for rice and I usually want it. When serving me, I choose the rice and then let them move on. When picking the protein, I make my selection and while they are scooping the chicken or whatever I will say, and can I have an extra amount of rice on top of the chicken. Since they are usually rushing, by the time I get to the word extra, they are already going for a second scoop of chicken, thinking that's what I was about to say before they hear me say it is more rice that I want. They'll usually leave the extra meat on there since it has already been put in the bowl. This was more useful years back when they used to be incredibly stingy about the amount of meat you got in your bowl. Yeah, but some of the workers will pick meat out of your bowl so you don't get too much. If you are in a larger city, there is a good chance that press and publicity screenings of movies are held in your area for free. Before the movie comes out, you just need to know where to look. This is how journalists have time to write a review in time for release, and sometimes PR firms want to generate buzz with the public. They're first come first served and you have to wait in line to get in sometimes. Eventually I got on the press list in my area by publishing reviews, which gets you a reserve seat. One year I saw close to 100 films for free, before they were in theaters. I had to change my phone number because I had a stalker. Signed up for all the food delivery apps as a new account instead of changing my old one. Got all the new customer deals again. I had internet provider convincing me I have to pay cancellation fee to get out of their network. It wasn't too much, but I didn't want to pay because I had dozen complaints reported about never having good internet. I just plugged in a new router with new provider, left the old one in the box and waited for 2 years. They sent me letters and threats and price with interest. It took them 90 days not paying a bill to cancel you themselves, so they added those 3 bills in. I simply ignored everything, and when the final warning came in the mail where they charged me for the router but bills have become obsolete because there wasn't any traffic recorded on them, I took the router box, left it at their shop with a note who it belonged to and walked out. Never heard from them again and never paid a dime. Patience is virtue. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Bye for now.